heartbreak kid stories. Okay, here we go. Now, if you remember, I took a trip from 2009 to 2008. And let's rewind back to 2007, because I've been to Miami, Georgia a lot. And it's time I bring this up. Emma Jones, during this time, came around during the beginning of my freshman year in high school. She came in the beginning of my freshman year. I just started high school. I was leaving a very bad year in middle school. Eighth grade year was the worst school year I've ever had in middle school, and in school in general. I never wanted to go there. I felt like I was cursed going to middle school. Everything just felt like a curse. The only silver lining in my eighth grade year in Jefferson Davis Middle School were my friends. My academic terrible, and worst of all, women I've been around were just so terrible to me. I've asked out so many friends, only to be told the same thing. Oh, I have a boyfriend. And the sad part is, a majority of these people lied. They lied. You know, they lied to me, you know, or they just never were honest. Only one girl was honest and straightforward and actually lifted me up. And that won't be mentioned until another time of day. But the rest of the girls, they just were terrible to me. I couldn't stand them. To get my hopes up, but I also learned that, you know, I shouldn't have asked girls out just because they looked good. And I wasn't no saint too when I treated Anisha Howard the way I treated her, even though she cheated. But I should have never gone out with her in the first place. So regardless of the situation, it was bad. Terrible.
Now approaching.
Terrible. And I never understood. So I'm coming off of this year hoping everything's different. You know, summer was pretty bad too, but I won't really get into that. All I'm going to get into is going to my freshman year. I was going into gym class in Westside High, also known as Nathan Bedford Forest at the time. Going to my freshman year. And I meet someone special. You know, I'm sitting in class, I'm sitting in the bleachers, just chilling, you know, doing me. And then I see a lovely Caucasian girl, and to no surprise, if you all know me, I have a thing for redheads, and she was that. She was redhead. I mean, it was mixed, but at the end of the day, you see it on the internet, and you see it translated to redhead. She was redheaded. That's what I did. So I got into a conversation with her. We talked about a lot of things. She just seemed cool. Then I asked for her name. She gave me her name though. Her name was Emma Jones. And I would eventually see her the next day. This was during the time we had four classes one day and four classes the other. had two first periods together. Well, seeing her every morning was amazing. We talked, I made her laugh. Everything was beautiful. Everything was great.
Please remain seated until the bus comes to a complete stop.
The other girls failed to do. You know, talking about the problem is, I've become very cynical and down at the dumps as I'm around animal channels.
Very.
And eventually,
I would cry, I would do a lot of stuff around.
I would get so depressed, it ended up turning her off. He had a girlfriend, he broke up with her just so she could talk to him. It was painful. It was incredibly painful to just sit there and watch. Them get along so well. It's painful to sit there and watch her get along with so many people. I never understood, you know, in my head, it's like, why is she getting along with this guy? What did I do, not knowing exactly what I've done? Because I'm so cynical at this time, not admitting my own guilt. That's become a problem, become a huge problem to me. And as this is going on, I'm just getting more depressed and more upset at myself. It's like, what am I doing wrong with all of her? Not even asking this girl out in the first place. Not even asking her out. I don't even have this girl out.
Please hold on while the bus is in motion. All passengers must remain behind the standing line while the bus
that
is in
really
motion.
Sucks.
Please notify operator before removing bike from rack.
But it is just painful to watch this girl just get disgusted every second of the day that I have. And I don't even mean it. You know? To me, it just was too much for me to accept.
And at the end of the day, when I looked at this, I looked at some of the things I've said to myself. Standard classes, because I should. As the second week starts, this girl, no, this girl did not want to go to course. She wanted to go to Ed White because her mother, her brother, like, it was a whole lineage. You know, the people wanted to pretty much, you know, she just wanted to go to Ed White and graduate, you know, but apparently, because of location issues, they forced her to go to course. And eventually,
The last time I ever saw him in person, and it was heartbreaking. And I'm thinking maybe I'll see her today. I go to gym and she's not there. I get dressed in my regular gym clothes and she's not there. And then maybe a couple of friends came up to me and just like, oh, what's the matter, Jamil? You gonna cry? Because they saw how close me and her were, at least in school, you know? And these friends were like really trying to, you know, say, hey, let's help you out here. I spent a majority of my time in gym just walking around alone. That's the first time I felt alone in my entire life. The first time I've ever felt alone in my entire life. And it was painful. I've been around a girl. I can honestly say that was my first. That was the first time, you know, I really liked someone and just got taken away from me. I felt like empty. I felt empty. You know, if I could grow the beard, I would grow it for that day because it would describe how I am. At the time, very disheveled. I don't think about going out. I didn't want to be in class. You know, I told people, hey, I just want to take some time outside. I want to cry about it. You know, I want to cry. Went on a bus and
please have your bus fare or pit pass ready.
I went on the bus and you know I went on the bus. I sat there, don't worry, I'm not crying, but I sat there, but I am a little choked up right now, it's hard to talk about. I sat there, just staring, it's going down again, eventually. Last time I cried that year, 2007, I cried a year ago. I have never cried going through the years of 8th grade that I went through. I never cried the way I cried. But I did. The first time I cried. Some people want to know what happened. Or why am I like this? You know, they've seen that. You know, I showed him the note the camera wrote to me before she left. And, you know, it felt bad, but people were trying to comfort me. But I remember my brother, and I don't, like, look, I don't want to make my brother out to be the villain, a bad guy. This is not the purpose. I'm sorry, Lawrence. I don't mean it. I'm not trying to make it out this way. I'm just saying my side of the story. And how it felt. But my brother sees me crying and sees stuff like this, and my brother's like, you know, like I said, my brother's just trying to be made. I guess my brother's trying to make me tough. But I had argued against why. I was against why he was making fun of me for this. But I cried. I cried, and he's like, dude, you should be crying for stuff like that. People leave all the time. It's silly. Why are you crying? You know? But my brother doesn't understand. Like I said, I my brother was trying to make it tough, but it was the fact that I've never felt secure and insecure at the same time. You know, going to school and taking the shit that I took back in 2007, my eighth grade year, taking the shit that I took, and I find security in someone, I find specialty in someone, and next thing you know, that person's gone and I have to go back into finding my own identity again. You know, every time, every year, to this day, like I can honestly tell you, even today, every time something is over between me and a girl where I can't be with them either anymore and at all, I have to search for my identity again. Because now you lose your identity within this person. You lose your identity within the person that you like. Because you just invested so much time in it. And now you have to go back. And some, you know, takes a while. Some it takes a while. Others, you know, it can be quick. But the rest is just, the rest of the times, it's just so forever. And it takes like it just never is going to happen. You know, people always tell me, you know, oh, you should get over such and such. You shouldn't worry about such and such. It's not about that. It's about the fact that I don't want to be taking the same walk back home to recovery land. I don't like this feeling of having to re-identify myself again. I don't like the feeling. Now I got to go back on this walk. On this path to recover myself, and it's only just another annoying, tedious thing to do. And I tell you, man, it hurts. It really, really hurts. The silver lining is it can happen. It's done, it's not forever. It takes a while, but sometimes it can take a while, but it gets the job done. And when it's done, you know that you'll finally be able to just do your thing. In this case, the camera. It took me 9 weeks to get over it. Plus, to get over the fact, because during the winter time I came to West Palm Beach for a vacation, and I'm over here and over, you know, the winter break, thanks for the winter break, I'm trying to rekindle a friendship, acting like nothing happened, and yet I don't seem to pay attention to the fact that Canada is done with me. She's done with my BS. I didn't know it. But at this time, she's like, I'm very upset, you know, at why, oh, we had an argument online. First time.